Hi, I'm Joe Galati, and I'm here with my mother-in-law, Margaret Ward, from Ireland. And a lot of people have been asking us how she makes her Irish bread. And it's not as complicated. There's a little bit of mystery behind it. But to answer the question and to show everybody, we have Mrs. Ward here at our house in Texas. And we are going to go step by step on how to make authentic Irish bread. So stay tuned, watch, and take notes.
Margaret, if you could first, just before we get into the details, just point out the different ingredients to make the bread. Why don't you start with the two types of flour here?
This is gold medal, white flour.
Right. So any white flour.
Flour doesn't have to be gold medal, it can be Pillsbury, as long as it's white flour.
Okay, white flour, and then what's the other one?
The other one is coarse wholemeal flour, coarse wholemeal. But you can't buy it here, except maybe in an Irish store here.
Right, but it is from Ireland, right?
It is from Ireland, Odlums wholewheat meal.
Right, now we looked on Amazon, you could buy the exact same thing for about $18, but in New York you get that for about $5, is that right? What do you buy it at ShopRite?
$5-$6.
Okay.
Yeah.
So those are the two flours. Then what else? What other ingredients here?
2 teaspoons of baking soda.
Okay.
2 level teaspoons of baking soda. 1 level teaspoon of salt.
Uh huh.
2 teaspoons of sugar. You could put 3 if you wanted to, but
okay.
I just put in 2.
Okay. And then what else? You mentioned something about oil.
And then I mix that all up very good, get it all blended together. Then use a tablespoon of oil and buttermilk.
And buttermilk, okay. Is that the secret ingredient, the buttermilk?
The buttermilk, yeah. You have to have buttermilk.
Okay. All right, so we'll start with the flour. How much of the white flour do you start off with?
3 cups of white flour.
3 cups
of white flour.
Of white flour.
Yes.
Now, when you're making this bread at home, Mom, do you normally have Irish music going or talk radio? Does it matter?
Doesn't matter to me.
Doesn't matter to you. Okay. And for everybody watching, what county in Ireland are you from?
County Monaghan.
Monaghan. Where is that located
near? It borders Northern Ireland. It's one of the 9 counties in Ulster, which is the north of Ireland.
Uh-huh.
But 6 counties belong to England.
Right. So 3 cups of the white flour. And as she said, any white flour, Pillsbury or the...
Oh, there's other white flours too, but I use Pillsbury or gold medal.
Nice and even. That's 2. And 3.
It's a little bit overwhelmed. Anyway.
Okay.
That's 3.
Okay, so now how much on the
3 of these.
Three of these as well.
3 of these. And this 3 of the wholewheat.
Wholewheat.
Coarse wholemeal flour.
Right. So it's 3 cups of white, 3 cups of the
coarse wholemeal.
Coarse.
That's 1. That's 3.
Okay. Right, so the next, sugar?
2 teaspoons.
2 teaspoons.
Doesn't have to be level.
Regular sugar, a little more or less, that's okay.
And then
a baking Arm & Hammer.
Arm & Hammer, 2 level teaspoons of baking
powder. 2 level teaspoons.
And a bruise it a little.
What does bruising do?
There can be lumps in the
okay.
In the baking soda.
No lumps in the baking soda. So it's 2 teaspoons sugar, 2 teaspoons baking soda.
Yeah.
Smash it up, de-lump it.
If there's any lumps in it, sometimes it can be.
Right.
And salt, 2 level teaspoons of salt.
2.
Yes.
So really, you don't have to be very good in math to do this. Just 2.
Yeah.
And 2. Okay, now,
the oil is olive oil. We didn't.
Yes.
Is it olive oil or? It's
olive oil.
Olive oil.
You can use olive oil. I could use glycerin oil, but I use olive oil.
You like? What do you like?
I
use the olive oil at home.
Get the olive oil. Okay.
But this has to be well stirred up first. You could use a sieve, you know, to mix it through.
Sure.
But if you blend it well enough, you know what? I go around it like this with the back of a spoon to make sure I get all the baking soda.
What about if you throw like a whisk or a fork? Does that...
Yeah, you could use a whisk too.
Yeah?
Yeah.
But the key is to get the ingredients...
It's to get it well mixed through.
Well mixed.
Yeah.
Okay. Get the salt, the sugar, the baking soda, and the two flours...
Leave the flour.
...put together.
I'll need the flour.
All right. And how much olive oil?
Tablespoon.
Now, when do you put that in?
I put it in when I'm putting in the buttermilk.
In the buttermilk, okay. Yeah. So now, a tablespoon of
oil.
Olive oil.
Olive oil.
Now that replaces the lard from years ago, right?
Years ago I used to use margarine and I'd make about an ounce or less, maybe half ounce of margarine, and bruise it all through. You'd have to use your hands to get it all blended
but
in.
But olive
through.
Oil is a lot easier.
But olive oil does the same job.
Right. A nice hefty tablespoon. Now with this, it's going to get a little wet. Do you mix it once the milk goes in, or do you
I just throw in the buttermilk.
You throw in the buttermilk now. Now, recap, how much buttermilk?
I don't throw it in, I pour it in.
You pour it in, sorry.
That's my fault.
How much buttermilk?
Oh, about a half of what? This is a big, what do you call it? That's not the same as the other container, right?
No.
This is a half a gallon, right?
Yes.
So, I put in a half a quart first.
A half a quart.
Half a quart, because I'd usually have a quart, and put in half of that, and then I might need a little more.
Okay, so how much is that? You put half of that in?
You don't want to get it too wet. You know, you have to have it at a certain consistency, kind of.
Right.
Okay. Here, it's easy.
Right, and how much again you want? How much?
You put in about a half of a quart first. How much is this? This is 1 cup. 8 ounces.
Okay, so we're going to put basically 16 ounces in.
Yeah.
That was your first cup. And buttermilk. You could get buttermilk at any grocery store. There you go. And then you're still with the same spoon. You don't need any fancy kitchen tools.
You need a good strong spoon. This is a good spoon for making
a bread. Good strong right arm, right?
I prefer, you know, a spoon like this. It's more like a soup spoon than a wooden spoon.
Okay. Now, I would think you have to really work all that liquid into the flour.
Yes, you have to work it in. And
now, do you ever find that you have to sprinkle in a little extra flour if it's...
No. You might have to put in a little more buttermilk, but I think I have enough here.
Right. Now, if it was too wet and you had to add more flour, would you go with the meal or the white flour?
I'd go with the flour, but...
The white flour or the brown?
Well, you could use either one, but it's better off not to have to do that.
Right.
I wanted to put any more buttermilk on that.
Now, is there such a thing as over beating this?
No.
Can you overdo it?
No, because you used to knead the bread. My mother used to take it out of the bowl and put flour around it and knead it. But I'm more or less kneading it with a spoon when I'm mixing it.
All right, so there's no concern of really overdoing it.
Oh, I need the pan. A square pan and spray it for me.
Sure.
Now, typically, what size? This is going to go in a 12 by 12.
What size is that pan?
Do you want this one?
This is the Galati test kitchen here.
This size.
Do you want to measure it?
Do you want butter on there?
Yeah, any kind. No, a spray of any kind, so that it doesn't stick.
So a little bit of Pam on there.
Pam.
So just a little bit of Pam. No butter on this, Mom?
No.
No butter. Just a little Pam.
And that looks like it's a 12 by 12 pan.
Make sure, will you hold that churning for me because it's heavy.
Turn it.
Make sure we get it all out.
I know. No waste in the ward house.
Now, you, when the kids were growing up, you said at least one of these a day? Sometimes two?
Yeah, I could, yeah. No, well, I said my mother in Ireland, like, we didn't have loaf bread much over there.
So right.
There was 10 of us and she made 6 cakes a day.
6 cakes a day?
Yes.
Holy crow. Now, do you...
I only make a couple of these, a couple of times. A
couple of weeks, you're slowing down.
Well, I mean, maybe when the kids were growing up, probably three a week.
3 a week?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, do you force it there, or do you sort of shake it into the corners?
Oh, no.
Gently. You want to get the air pockets out, right?
Yeah, you want to get it spread out, but I'm going to be using my hands in a minute.
Uh-huh. And that's the perfect consistency that you like?
Yeah. It could have been just a little less.
A little less what?
A little less buttermilk.
Okay.
But it's okay. It's not all.
Okay.
I have to use my hands.
It's okay. I saw you wash them today.
Oh, I will.
Now, if you went to a typical Irish house back in Monaghan.
Yeah.
Would people be making this same recipe to it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
See what I'm saying?
So this recipe hasn't died. Now you're just throwing this on top?
I'm putting it on so I can...
Oh, so you're gonna... Okay.
So I can go like this, flatten it out.
So you're gonna...
I've got to get flour on my hands.
So you're not mixing it, you're just...
No, I'm just spreading it out.
All right, you see that technique she's got there? And just a fine dusting, right?
Yeah. As long as I keep my hands from sticking to it.
Right.
I like to get it out. 4 corners.
Yeah.
As good as I'll get it.
Yeah. Wait, this is her signature.
Wait, now this is the signature. We have to get this. What do we got here? What do you do?
I just make a cross. Like that. This way you can cut it in squares or half.
Okay.
And to do this.
Oh, really?
I don't know why. Maybe it's to let air out or something. I have no idea why they did this. Everybody did this with a bread.
So just a little mark.
A little mark. That's it.
That's it.
That's it.
You sure? There's nothing?
No, there's nothing else.
Nothing else fancy? No sprinkles? No,
no
nothing?
Nothing.
Okay, so now the oven. How hot is the oven?
It has to be at 400 degrees.
400.
For 1 hour.
1 hour.
1 hour.
Now, silly question. It may not matter. Top shelf, middle, lower shelf?
In the middle.
Right in the middle?
Right in the middle.
Okay.
And you don't have to, you can, if there's a light in the oven, you can look through, but you don't really have to look in it.
You don't have to look at
as
it.
As long as it's not going to, at 400.
400, 1 hour.
1 hour, and it's done.
Okay. So let us take it in.
Well, I don't want to put my hand on this. I'll have everything covered with flour.
Don't burn yourself.
Is that 400, is that 400 yet? Oh, it is. Here's it.
Almost. It's getting there.
Almost 400. Close it.
It's only
okay.
350.
So now we have an hour. You and I will play some cards or something.
Yeah.
Okay.
We can clean up after.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm waiting on this to go up.
Right.
It should have been at 400 before I put it in, but it's okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. All right. So we'll resume in an hour.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
And we won't tape you washing the dishes. There you go. Let's look at those hands. Let's
see. Hands.
There you go. That you for everybody listening or watching, your hands got to look like that.
Yeah. Oh.
All right. This is the side.
Take my ring out of it.
This is
the after effect of making the Irish bread. Okay, we'll be back in an hour, okay?
Yes.
All right, so, Margaret, an hour is up.
Yes.
No more, no less.
No more. Well, it could be a couple of minutes more, wouldn't do it any harm, but...
Yeah.
Narrow exit.
Okay, always wear hand protection.
Yes.
Oh, the big countdown. Two. There you go.
Hold on.
Shut that off. All right.
Yep.
Out of the oven. Yep. Holy crow, look at the way you handle that thing. So you dump it out right away.
Dump it out.
Onto a rack.
Just turn it over quick. Let it cool.
And that is it.
That's it. That's your cake of bread, Joe.
Now, how long before we let it?
Oh, it takes a couple of hours for it. A
couple hours to cool off?
Yeah.
You're not going to allow me to cut a piece now? What would happen if I cut it now?
It probably would it.
Yeah, it spoils it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How's it sound?
You have to.
Oh, it's fine. I don't do that at home. I used to do that to see if it.
Now, I know you were
butter. Toasted and butter, and
you
you're in heaven.
You don't have to toast it when it's fresh. When it gets maybe 2 or 3 days old, you can toast it if you want to.
Right.
But when it's fresh, I wouldn't think of toasting it.
Yeah.
What are you saying?
I said I like it toasted.
You want to toast it?
Jerry likes it toasted
with melted butter.
Melted butter.
So, any other tips?
Nice,
any other tips?
Nice when it's cold and you slice it and put plenty of butter on. Put some marmalade on top. Oh, that's good too.
That's heaven. All right. Well,
yeah.
We'll get this posted and yeah. I'm sure a lot of people are going to be making this bread.
Oh, God.
All right.
You think you're going to post that and people will make this?
Yeah. Why not?
Yeah. I hope they can find the whole wheat meal.
Yeah. Well, they got the name of it and they'll find it. So. Yeah. We'll get there.
Yeah.
If not, write to Margaret Ward and you could help everybody. All right.
Oh, gosh.
Adios. Any final words on your roots in Ireland and
all the bread you made?
This is where I learned how to make bread, watching my mother and my aunt when she came out to this country. She brought me out here, my sister. And she was making bread when I got here. She was only here a year already.
Right.
And she made bread, and then I watched her. And
here we
started
are.
Making it then too.
All right. Yeah. All right. Well, thanks.
Oh, it's very healthy. It's very healthy bread.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Well, thanks.
And I hope everybody, anybody that's, you'll tell somebody how to bake it or show them the
video. Yeah, we'll show them the video.
The video and, hopefully people will make it and enjoy it.